The Philippine Justice Secretary vows a thorough case buildup on the possible charges they may file against former President Rodrigo Duterte over his bloody drug war. Secretary Crispin Remulla says this will ensure the potential charges against Duterte would stand well in court. A task force probing the war is eyeing an international humanitarian law case against Duterte. Remulla believes the former president's admission he told police to urge drug suspects to fight back is a crucial admission over the bloody campaign.
It speaks of a solution to a problem which ends up in the death of people. And I think that's very damning. The fact that the order to kill is couched in that language. It's itself very damning because the intent to kill is always there. It is not really, it is just something that can be justified by the circumstances being raised by the former president. Even with all the pressure that comes to us about a lot of people being impatient and wanting us to file cases immediately, mm-hmm. we still believe that we have to build up the cases because a strong built-up case will always be ready for trial anytime, and that we can finish the trial within a record time.
Secretary Remulla maintains the Philippines can investigate the drug war killings without having to rejoin the International Criminal Court. The tribunal is conducting a similar investigation into Duterte's war on drugs.
I don't see it as a necessity. It is something that we can live without. Or not being a member of the ICC. It's just that we have to deal with all of these international tribunals sooner or later. Our sovereignty and our legal system allows us to deal with them with our own law.
And let's now go over to the House of Representatives, where a panel resumed its inquiry over the alleged misuse of government funds by the office of Vice President Sara Duterte. Our very own Vivian Gulia now on the line with the details. Viv, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Alleged questionable acknowledgement receipts submitted by the office are the offices led by Vice President Sara Duterte to the Commission on Audit continue to be the focus of today's hearing of the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability. House Assistant Majority Leader and Lano del Sur First District Representative Dia Alonto Abiong flagged two acknowledgement receipts supposedly submitted by the OVP and the Department of Education, which were signed by one name, but he observed that the signatures and the penmanships were different. The receipts were part of the thousands of AR submitted to justify the confidential expenses of the two offices then led by Duterte. Abiong said it is highly unlikely that two individuals with the same name signed the receipts in question, prompting him to suspect that there were alleged abuses in the use of government funds. Duterte previously said that there was no misuse of confidence of public funds in her office. The committee plans to consult a penmanship expert to help address the questions raised by lawmakers on acknowledgement receipts, including those supposedly signed by the different individuals, but the penmanship appeared similar. It will also coordinate with the Philippine Statistics Authority to help verify the identity of a certain Mary Grace Siafos, who supposedly signed at least one of the ARs submitted by the OVP to justify its 2022 confidential expenses. During the hearing, the OVP's Assistant Chief of Staff, Assistant Secretary Lemuel Ortonio, has been cited in contempt anew by the House panel over his continued defiance of the committee's order to attend its hearings, which it viewed as a sign of disrespect. He was ordered detained at a prison in Bicutan for 10 days. OVP's Chief of Staff, Attorney Zulaika Lopez, who attended Wednesday's hearing, told the panel that she has not seen Ortonio since returning to work just yesterday, and that based on her understanding, Ortonio is on official travel. Three other OVP officials continued to skip the House panel hearing today, and Adyong said that there appears to be a deliberate attempt to frustrate the committee. House Deputy Speaker and Quezon 2nd District Representative David Suarez urged the panel to look into possible administrative sanctions against government personnel who continue to defy the invitations, subpoenas, and contempt orders issued by the lower house. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Vivian Gulia, there joining us on the line.